Yeah, welcome to the... Oh, never mind. Wait, just saw that there's the wrong title. Like, test... let me change that. Quickly. Yeah, welcome to the Lobby B for Lobby 2 stream. Yeah, sounds quite weird, but we also are streaming Lobby 1 at Helen's channel. Yeah, till now I am the only commentator for that one. Jacob said that he wanted to commentate it with me, but until now he did not appear. Never mind. There he is. Yeah, hello. My second commentator arrived.
I just was eating and finished like 2 minutes ago.
Alright.
So we have Team Rusty Trollers plus plus N. Okay, that name is pretty hard to pronounce. Enjuji? Enjuji?
What? No, Enjuji is not on the team. We have Spunout, Gumi, Move. Wait, what? No, we have Multipan Fortnite 90 degrees.
I see the wrong
yeah,
stream.
Okay, we have Multipan Fortnite 90 degrees with Spunout, Gumi, Movement, and Shirokyu. Like the one with Enjuji is it's gonna be streamed on the other like on the channel from Helen.
Yeah, I just realized that I'm in the wrong stream.
And we're just starting off with the first map, that's Nomad 1. We already saw some nice scores on that today. Maybe we will see some nice ones again. Actually think so, because Gumi, Spunout and Movement are pretty good players.
That's actually a pretty solid team.
Yeah, Spunout is consistent on such a star rating as well. Like he played on the tournament last year as well, and he did very good scores.
I mean, Gumi is also very consistent on lower star range as well as like 6 star range. But I'm not quite sure how his tournament nerfs are.
Yeah, the same goes to Shirokyu. I really don't know how good he can perform at such a tournament setting. And also asking myself, like, what scores he will do on this nerf pool. I know that he's quite good at speed. Like, maybe he can show us something good at like DT2, but yeah, let's just hope that they will get great scores.
Yeah, we'll see it. It will probably be an exciting qualifier match to watch. I expect some good scores, especially on the consistent picks like Nomad 1, Hidden 1, DT1 probably also. This team will perform pretty well. So let's see. So everyone's starting off with pretty good egg, except for Shirokyu. He's a little bit struggling in the beginning here. But I'm sure that he will recover. we even have two SSs still ongoing. Okay, never mind, I just jinxed it.
Yeah.
The car suckers.
Somehow, spun out the first one was a break.
Oh, whoa, I didn't see that.
That's quite interesting.
Yeah, that's nothing that I would have expected from him, but maybe... Nice, Cursor doesn't look like he has nerves problem right now.
But still, like, 99% on three players, and that's really nice.
As expected, we have on Nomad 1 the consistency map, good performance of this team to this point. Oh, there's Shiro-Q. The player struggling with this map. On 92% egg.
I mean, until his break, he still was of seeing.
That's true.
That's not too bad.
We are still here with two FCs for Gumi and Movement. Movement with quite really good egg. Gumi also with a solid 99.3 accuracy.
Yeah, and Spawn also was 99.5. And he's also recovering his combo to support the full combo scores.
We can see Shiro-Q is still a bit struggling with this map.
Yeah, he's missing a lot.
But he can be happy that all other three members of his team are to this point very consistent with very good egg on this map. Maybe we can see a two-way FC here, but let's not jinx it.
Yeah, Shiro again was a break, but at that point he don't need to feel sad about it, because he just getting carried by three teammates.
Wait, did Movement break? Or wait, did he shake his cursor?
I don't know if he... No, he still have full combo.
It's probably because he's... Ah, no, because he egg choked. He dropped
the egg.
0.6% egg there.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. Looks like
performance is so strong. Yeah.
Looks like it that will be the best score, Nomad 1 score till now. I mean, I don't know how it looks like at lobby 1 right now, but I don't think that they on the other lobby they will get a higher score than them.
It's hard to beat the score. I mean, two FCs with both above 99% accuracy, and Spun Out with also a 700k score. Two set breaks for him.
Yeah, I probably need to write Molly that she needs to wait a bit that we can say something about the scores. Because when she's switching to the next map so fast, then the scores will disappear. Also, she still needs to add with me. No one doing that.
So far for the first map, the team can be very proud. I bet that Spun Out is a bit hard with himself that he broke on this map, because he knows as well as we both know that he can FC that. But let's see. We hop into the second map, the Sakura Mirage, Burst Heavy Nomad 2 with 187 BPM. And let's see if they can keep up the good performance. I expect an FC from Spun Out and Gumi probably, because Gumi improved on Burst and streams in the last few days. for movement. I don't know if this is his skill set, but I'm sure he can do something good on that. And we see already Shiro struggling again a little. Let's see if he can still get a nice combo. He looks so nervous, to be honest. If you look at his UR bar, it's all over the place. Like, I think he's struggling to concentrate on the streams and tap as he hears the sound. Umi with quite impressive egg, 99.8% accuracy. Okay, never mind. There he dropped to 100. And so far, they look good on this map.
Yeah, Gumi still with a very sane accuracy. Above 99.7 now. Never mind, I just jinxed it.
Yeah, I jinxed it before and I didn't want to say anything again about his egg, because when you talk about it, it just instantly drops.
Wait, did he like SS till you said something about his accuracy, or?
He dropped some 100s in the beginning, like in the first 100 combo, but he recovered his egg to like 99.8, and just as I said that, he dropped 100s. Like, now. It happened just again. Holy shit, the caster curse is just real.
Like usual.
Yeah.
Maybe damn, I just Shiro remember can... just remember how unfortunate that was, that my team was able to 4-way FC it till the end and then we all just won this at nothing.
I saw it in the replay. I watched the stream and
I had like the worst nurse or like shake I ever had.
Yeah, I saw that. You fucking curse it then.
Just
the stream.
Some Parkinson shit.
Oh wait, I didn't notice the spun out dropped his combo.
Oh yeah, he did.
Before the end part.
So there's only a 2-way FC, but hey,
still
I mean,
a very, very good team score.
2-way is very good, so
almost 3 million score. And I mean, Shiro kinda inted on that one, but
yeah. I mean, Gumi still with a 99% accuracy FC, and so they should be fine. Also, like Mufin with FC with 98% accuracy, and yeah, spun out.
Yeah, the break from spun out, I didn't really unlucky. See it, but I think it was on a jump or a slider, because it's just a one miss, and he didn't drop 50s.
Still,
so it's.
Still,
probably not on the stream.
Still a very, very nice egg. Almost 99% from him as well, but yeah. It's very sad that he dropped his full combo. Just need to switch the lobby for a short moment that I can maybe see the chat on. Yeah, so the chat appeared now. Because Molly addressed me. Short time after I like get into the lobby. Yeah, so can see now what they are writing in the chat.
And the first thing we see.
Uwu Oni-chan, 187 BPM, incident number 2, Jesus Knast.
Oh no.
Yeah, but like spun out already sent this message in our Twitch chat.
So. Yeah, I just saw that too. Okay, now we go in one of the harder maps of the pool, I would say, the Nomad 3. here again, I only know that Gumi can probably play alternate pretty well. For Spun Out, he's probably just doing some single tap stuff. And Movement and Shiro, I don't know if they can play or can't play this map.
Well, I don't know if Spun Out is able to single tap it, but he probably can.
Yeah,
he's probably I saw a lot of things Spun Out just single tapped, and they were just very crazy.
Yeah, the BPM of this alternate map isn't that high.
So maybe he can probably. So yeah.
I bet we'll see some single tap things going on.
I mean the one thing is that we still like he can maybe single tap it, but if he can also get a good accuracy, that's like the other thing you have to think of.
But so far, he's looking good, I would say.
Yeah, so far it's looking quite good.
But let's see if he can hold that performance for the rest of the map. Because if he really wants to single tap the whole map, then after this map, the single tap stamina probably will be drained a little.
I mean, also, like, this map has one pattern with many of doubles, and maybe he will break on this because he's trying to single tap it.
Let's see. Maybe even his aim is a little worse when single tapping on this BPM, but he's probably still gonna get a nice score. And we just saw before the break that Shiro broke on, I would say, nothing. And it's a bit sad for him, I would say.
Yeah. But as I know, and you can like barely see it, Shiro's skill set isn't alternating. Like, he struggles a lot on alternate maps, as I can remember, right?
And I mean,
you can see it.
He don't has the worst score that we saw.
Yeah, you're right. I think he's also like working on get good at alternate, but yeah, like he still have some problems on this map, but he has above like 80% accuracy, so that's alright. We have seen worse than that, especially with like accuracy. I think like in the last lobby we had I'm not quite sure. I think like two plays at Hardtalk 2 had 70% accuracy. And I think also the two guys had bad egg at this one. And yeah, I already said that Spun Out will probably miss on that pattern.
Yeah.
So yeah, it actually happened. Movement.
Gumi slider broke on a much sadder part just after the halfway point. That's so much score that he's missing now.
Yeah.
Like, you can already see Spun Out just hit 100 or 200 combo more than him and is 200,000 score ahead. So Gumi just lost the opportunity for a 700k score there.
Well, yeah. Movement, the only one with a high combo. But it isn't a full combo though, so yeah, that's pretty sad.
Yeah, Movement also broke, I think, right before the halfway point. So all the breaks of this team were on such set timing points of the map that they're missing a whole lot of score. Okay, there goes Gumi and Spun Out again with another break.
Sometimes I just don't understand what happens on like on decline. Like Movement had 300k 10 seconds before the map has ended, and now he has 500k. Just got 200k from decline in the last 10 seconds.
Laser client is a little buggy, I would say.
Not the laser client. It's like the normal auto client. Not streaming the laser client. Also, I mean, to stream the laser client, you need the normal OSU client. Laser client is only for the design and something like that. Unfortunately, I can't like do it like Helen and Leo as like they are streaming with laser client because I am I don't have two monitors, only one. And yeah, you need two for streaming laser. But until now, it's fine, and there's no problem with it. Only that, yeah, the client is buggy sometimes, but this problem is also at, like, the people who's using the laser client. Yeah, going for the last normal map now. Do you think that there will be more full combos than on the map right now, on the map we have seen?
I think we'll see one or two FCs. Nomad 4 isn't actually that hard to play, because like the difficulty of the map just is like straight line. It's consistent from the beginning onwards. But if you have nerfs on Nomad 4, it can really destroy your whole score. Like in the middle we have these slow slider sections, and I guess we'll see a few breaks on that part, but let's see. To mention again the thing with the break in the middle of Gumi, he had only 110 combo less than Spun Out, and he was missing 100k score. That's too it was such a sad timing for his break. Okay. We see some accuracy issues on Gumi's side here, but I guess it were just some starting problems and he'll get into the map. Hero is also actually playing this map pretty good, when you compare it to the performance on Nomad 2, because it's also a little stream heavy. This Nomad. Oh, and I just jinxed him. Yeah. Yeah, and as we see, Gumi movement and Spun Out all with about 98% movement, actually with almost 99%. That's a pretty impressive act for this map. And I think now we are soon into the more slider heavy part, like more...
Yeah, movement is breaking.
Oh, yeah.
And
oh no.
He's very tilted.
I mean, he broke right before the slow section.
Oh no.
And it's again... exactly in the middle of the map. That's... oh my god.
That's unfortunate.
This team has... is so unlucky with the timing of the breaks. It's incredible.
Yeah, like... but we... if you miss in the middle of a map, then... such a huge amount of score is going away. Just so unlucky.
But that are that are the score V2 things. We see Shiro now with a break again. I think he holds a pretty good combo until that point, because he's at 200k score, what is his best performance until now, I think, on any map. Or did he on Nomad 1 perform better? I'm not quite sure.
And I think he had a bit better performance at Nomad 1, but I'm not sure.
As we now go in the last few seconds of the map, we still have the two FCs, and I guess that's gonna be it for the map.
Yeah, looks like they will two-way FC it. And yeah, they did. That's a nice two-way full combo we have seen there.
And from we can see Gumi. Movement is just missing 500k score.
Yeah, and that's moaning about it after it happened.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Yeah, but I like 98.5% accuracy from Spanout and 97 from Umi. Yeah, looks fine.
And it's still a pretty good team performance. I think they had like 2.7 million around that range.
2.6, I guess.
Yeah, 2.6 it should be. That's a really strong performance of the team. And yes, we can see on all four nomads, we had a score around the 3 million point mark, and that is actually a very consistent and good performance. Like, they had no map that was below the 2 million mark, if I recall correct. So, soon we are hopping into the first hidden map, which has quite a few weird sliders. But overall, it's not that bad to play. Yeah, let's see. Probably they're gonna all perform pretty good on that one. I don't know, Nicorax, do you know if Shirokyu is good at hidden?
I don't know. I don't think so. If I remember right, he has some problems on hidden, and especially on hidden 2 maps.
Oh.
Because he isn't playing that much hidden, so. But, like, this map has not that hard reading patterns. It's only some square patterns with hidden.
Yeah,
and some
sliders. I think the hardest part of the hidden one is actually the sliders.
Yeah.
Because most of them have like a very unconventional design. Like, we have many circle sliders and waves that have a really weird angle. But I bet they're gonna perform pretty good on this one as well. Okay, and there we hop into the first hidden of this pool.
Oh no, there's the first one who rides among us.
Oh no.
And of course it's Gumi.
Gumi banned for next tournament. No Among Us here.
Oh no, movement was the... I don't know on what he missed there or slider broke, but...
Did he actually break?
Yeah, he broke at the beginning. I don't know why.
Oh man. So, yeah. I thought we were banshot by the client.
No, it clearly was a break.
But I mean, it's only like 55 combo that he's missing. That's gonna be like 50k.
No, it's some more. It's, I think it's like 40 combo points. Like, yeah, more than 40 combo points.
Yeah, 55, I think. Yeah, around this range somewhere. And
but he still have more points than Spawner than Gumi. No, never mind. Oh, alright, the client just debated myself. I just looked very scuffed. Like, for a short moment, movement had 280 points and Spawner than Gumi only 210. It was very, very weird.
Is actually performing very good on this one. It's his best map for now.
Oh no, everyone just writes the Ubu Oni-chan 187 thing.
Oh no.
That's gonna be a new meme for the tournament. Oh, damn.
So
looks like
see...
that we will see a three-way FC. Alright, oh. Never mind. Never mind.
But that's such a good team score.
Yeah, 3.7 million is the best we did see until now. Like, almost a four-way FC. Like, movement, reverse choked it, and Spawnout, yeah, missed at the ending.
Because this map doesn't have that much combo, this 55 combo that he's missing are more than 100,000 points that are away from his score. That's unlucky again, but the team performance on this map is really outstanding. I don't know, did we have a team that performed better on this?
No, that's,
I don't think so.
That's the best score until yet. Until now, so there's no team what got over 3.7 million.
I think on Hidden 2, your team is on the hashtag one spot right now.
You mean in, like in, on each map? Like...
No, only on the Hidden 2.
Yeah, Hidden 2, yeah, because we...
Yeah, you almost 4-way FC'd.
We 3-way FC'd it, not,
yeah.
Not almost 4-way, because Horst had some problems on it.
But... Yeah, on the stream he misaimed.
Yeah.
Let's see, maybe they can beat your performance, because in the Hidden 1,
I know that Gumi had... already said that it's a very easy Hidden 2 map, but Spun Out is and also movement are not like the players who are well known for their hidden reading. I mean, Spawnout hates hidden though, so I don't know how good they will play on it. The same goes to Shirokyu. I don't think that he is that good at hidden reading.
Yeah, the message in the chat already shows us what
Colin
he thinks about the Hidden 2.
Yeah. I am really sure that they will not get a three-way full combo, but... Maybe they will surprise us. Maybe a miracle will just appear.
Okay,
prove
let's
me
see.
Wrong. And yeah, I need to...
Movement is on the wrong map.
I need to panic. Because, yeah, movement was on the wrong map in client.
Okay, there we go. Client syncing up.
Yeah. And we are there again. Everyone still with a SS. Never mind. I mean, it was just a joke though, because... Yeah, but Gumi and Spawn actually just choked their 100% away. Shiro also was the first miss.
Oh, Shiro, yeah.
And movement was the second.
Oh, movement.
So
clearly
they,
having
they,
some problems here.
The funny thing is they can snipe us. No, because movement broke his FC, or like his combo.
Spunout is actually having a pretty good time on this map, for the things he said in the chat. Surprised that he can keep up this egg and
yeah,
play this confident.
He will probably get more than 300k.
Yeah. But we see movement and Shiroku both having troubles getting into the map. They can't build up a good combo.
I would say they are having just some skill issues.
But Gumi and Spunout now both with almost the same accuracy and...
Yeah, Gumi broke his full combo away, unfortunately. Spunout, the last one was his full combo run.
Just wanted to say movement building up some nice combo there, but he broke in the exact moment I wanted to say it. And we see Gumi also breaking again.
So yeah, you just jinxed two players in like 10 seconds.
The job of the caster.
Oh so no, and Spunout also. Yeah, that's unfortunate.
But I mean, he doubled our expectations.
Yeah, he did. Like, almost 700k. I actually thought that he will get only like 300-400k. But yeah, he did very well.
Yeah, his accuracy not that good, but... I mean, the score overall, 700k,
it's fine. It will be on the, like, will be one of the best team performances on that, because till now, like, every map, every team, had some problems on that one. If you don't think of our team and their team. Because we moved it very well. Especially we with our three-way FC, that was kind of crazy. But yeah, we probably gonna see some epic shit on Hardrock maps. Because Spunout is like one of the players on this tournament who are very good at Hardrock.
Yeah, for me the Hardrock maps are like the hardest. I mean, on the Hardrock 1, I had trouble keeping my egg above 90%. Yeah, let's see.
I mean, I think, like, Spunout, Movement and Gumi will not have that problems to FC Hardrock 1 or Hardrock 2. They should be very easy for them, because they are all very consistent at Hardrock, usually.
Let's see if they have problems getting into the map because of the quick AR change from 8 to 10.
Yeah, some accuracy problems at the beginning, but yeah, like I said, it's only the beginning. You can push the egg very high in very short time again.
I think they're gonna get used to the AR again, like in a few seconds they probably will perform a lot better.
Chiru also still with the combo.
Yumi dropped very much egg on that stream there.
And movement was the first full combo loss.
Hirokyo actually holding the FC. I thought he was gonna be the first one of the four to break.
Yeah, I did not expect that he can combo the map.
Yeah, I mean he's literally combo gaming right now if you look at
his accuracy. Yeah, his accuracies. But also the accuracy from movement is like lower I did expect from him.
Yeah, spun out here very confident with almost 97% accuracy. Gumi also with the FC and almost 90%.
Yeah, Gumi also 88%. I actually thought that Gumi and exactly movement would get above 90%. Or like 94% accuracy or something like that.
Yeah, movement really has problems adapting to the higher AR after they played the hidden.
And I think that, like Gumi, the only one with the full combo now.
And movement building up a quite nice supporting combo there. Let's see, if movement can combo through the rest of the map, he's gonna end up on like 450k score or something like that. That would be huge for the team score if he can hold that.
It would be.
Spun out also still looking solid. I think his break really was unlucky and he would full combo this map in 9 out of 10 cases, and he just has this one case where he doesn't. And as we come into the last seconds, we will probably see the FC from Gumi.
We did. Gumi has healed, movement and spun out with some combos at the end.
And movement actually did hold his combo, so he ended up on 560k score.
And also, Gumi was the perfect combo, and Booth actually got above 90% at the end. It's nice to see.
Yeah, sad that Spun Out didn't get to full combo this map.
Yeah, very unfortunate.
That would be around 1 million score, probably, with this egg.
But actually, I'm surprised that Chiro got above 250k. That's very good for him.
Yeah, he did hold a very, very good combo in the beginning. I think he did hold like 500 or 600 combo. That is very, very good for the team score there.
Yeah, very strong.
So, now we go into the, for me, actually easier Hard Rock map.
Yeah, because it's lower in star rating, and also it's not like that it's hard to aim. I mean, the circles aren't that small. It's like CS 5.7. It's not even really precision for me, because if I'm playing precision maps, then I really mean like CS 6.5 to CS 7. But like it's different to like players who aren't usually playing maps like that. So maybe it's small enough to miss aim something for them. It feels like for players who aren't like playing precision maps.
If I would have to describe the Hard Rock 2, I would just say it's the Hard Rock 1 with a little lower spacing
and more finger control, I guess.
Yeah, it's a little finger control-y, but...
Like it has more bursts and stuff.
Yeah, but I think that's not gonna be the problem for this team. Maybe for Shiro, because we saw him struggling on the Noma 2. But we'll see.
I think I'm gonna say that Shiro probably gonna have below 80%. Also, probably below, like, yeah, 70% accuracy. I mean, until now he has, like, above 70, but yeah, he has some tapping issues.
We already saw that on the Nomad 2. Like, his UR bar was all over the place.
Yeah.
But maybe he can, if they qualify, he can fix his tapping issues.
Also, Shiro again, like, holds his FC longer than movement.
Movement did actually break.
Yeah, he broke before Shiro.
Yeah, I didn't notice that because I didn't expect him to break. I was quite sure he would hold his FC. And we can see again spun out with the best accuracy on the team here.
Also spun out and Gumi still with the full combos, but I don't want to jinx anything, but so please just FC it.
The spinner also... Oh... I think you jinxed one. But let's hope at least spun out can hold until the end. Movement also with a nice supporting combo again. He's probably gonna end up on like 630k score. It was more. And there we have a solid team performance again, 2.4 million score. And we see. 727, so no dropped slider ends there. And now we go into the DT pool. And I think on the DT2 we will see some very harsh problems on Shiroku's screen. Because that one is even more finger control heavy, but for the DT1, I actually think that he's gonna perform pretty good on it. See in the chat some discussions between the ref and the players about what to farm and what not to farm. And now we hop into the first of the two DTs. And I hope we're gonna see a good team performance again on this one.
How long was I muted? Like...
For 1 or 2 minutes.
No! Gabby just said right now that Shiro probably gonna... Like, this is the most possibility for a map that he can full combo maybe.
Yeah, I also thought about that.
He can play such maps very good with double time. I mean,
we hope that that the pressure isn't too high on him and he's gonna have nerve problems in the end.
What? Burnout was actually was the first miss. Like, I somehow saw them to four-way as it, but like, Burnout, I don't know what happened there.
Yeah, but
yeah,
such a sad break again. Burnout having problems with some shit misses on these maps. Like, he can, and that's something everyone probably knows, Burnout can FC every map in this pool. He is very solid on all of these maps. But as we saw, he has problems with his shit misses. He misses on easy parts.
Damn. Also, like, Shiro, it's the first time that Shiro has probably accuracy above 95%.
That's actually true. Oh my god.
And hopefully he will FC it, because that would be very nice for him.
Yeah, now every combo is very important, because like we saw,
no!
Oh my god.
Oh no!
Why
did I just
mention, why would we mention it?
Why? Why
we should
we
have just
that?
Ignored everything that, that happened on his screen. Oh no. But we still have a two-way FC until now.
Also, Spunout was a very good supporter combo.
Yeah, that's actually true. We can...
Oh my god, what was that for a miss from Shiro?
I didn't see it.
That was such a pain miss.
So, as we go now into the last 20 to 30 seconds of the map, we still have the two FCs of Movement and Gumi.
Oh my god! That can't be real!
Okay, I think I'm leaving now.
Oh my god!
This can't be real. At least we have the FC of Movement and the crazy supporting combo of Spunout. Oh my god.
Still a good team performance though.
Yeah, the 3.5 million score on the BT1.
Yeah.
It's very solid.
Could have been a 3 or 4 way FC, like Spunout only, Slider Bro get nothing, and Shiro shit missed very, very sadly. Also, Gumi broke on nothing, so yeah, that's very sad. Yeah, Gumi just yeah.
No one did jinx you. You just
Jacob
broke.
Jacob jinxed you.
No. Oh my god, this can't be real. Okay, now we get to the map that I think Shiro will have the most problems with, to be honest.
Yep. I'm not quite sure, because Shiro is quite good at speed, so he should be able to hit the bursts, but I'm not sure if he can like hold on the sliders, etc.
Yeah, I thought that because this map is also kinda finger control heavy, that he's having problems there, or will have problems there. But maybe he can cheese through that part and hold combo.
I mean, like, this team should be quite good for speed picks. Like, yeah, Spunout can play, is like a godly on speed maps. Movement also very good at speed. Gumi also can play speed maps, and yeah, Shiro also playing very, very much of speed maps.
Okay. There we go into the last map of the pool.
To be honest, I think we maybe could see a 4-way FC from them on that one. Or at least a 3-way. But yeah, I'm actually believing in Shiro.
Much better than I thought.
I'm believing in Shiro. Also, the map is only 2 minutes long, so it's doable. And yeah, like you can see, Shiro can easily like get this burst. But no, movement is the first one who is breaking.
Now all eyes on Shiro. He's the one to save the freeway FC. Let's just hope that Gumi and Spun Out won't break on like nothing again.
Yeah, I mean, like, oh no, Shiro just broke. That's sad.
There goes our.
But yeah, I mean,
freeway FC.
You saw that, like, Shiro is actually very good at stuff like that. Like,
yeah, that's actually surprising me because I thought, like, because he didn't perform well on the Noma 2, I thought it's just his stepping in general.
Oh no! But and now Spun Out, the only one was the full comment. Did you see this ladder wreck from Shiro?
No, I was just stunned by.
That was just such a troll break. And he also like wrote ach so. Because yeah, it was such a troll break.
So to finish my sentence, I thought that Shiro has problems with his tappings and tapping in general, but it just seems like he can't control it that well.
Yeah, it's just his finger control what like give him some problems. But
Spun Out
he
with
has
the best FC
until
so
now,
far.
I guess. Yeah. Very, very insane accuracy, like almost 99% FC, that's the best we got till now, and yeah.
Gumi also with a strong S rank, sadly a slider break, but almost 700k score for him.
Well,
and yeah,
that's a GG's, just gonna see if the first lobby is still going on, but I don't think so, because why should they need longer than us? Yeah, they're just playing DT2 and right now, and it's basically finished. Yeah, then I just gonna say, Molly Sandera, thanks for reffing the lobby to the players. Thanks for playing, and also thanks for commentating with me, Jacob.
Yeah, no problem. It was pleasure for me.
Well, then, yeah, thanks for watching the stream. We're just gonna see us in like 1 hour and 4 minutes, where there will be a second Lobby 2 stream for B5. And yeah, then you will see us there, and yeah, see ya. We'll be right back.
Thank you.